Well, hello there, boys and girls, and other subcultures of the internet. I'm not entirely sure what's wrong with my webcam. It's all like slow and chunky and stuff, so I'm gonna try and work on fixing that. So, rocking the little braids today because basically shows that I didn't even try. I can't even talk. I haven't made one of these in a while. Which means it's that part of the show where I get to talk about something that's probably really important to me that you probably don't care about, but it ends up being a fun story anyway. So I'm gonna talk about a topic that's very, I just stepped on my Xbox cord and that makes me unhappy. Sorry. It's the Turtle Beach headset pluggy thing. It runs all the way across the room because apparently to use Turtle Beach headsets, you have to be literally attached to your television. That's a completely different video blog thing. Back onto my topic, which again is probably important to me, but isn't important to you, but it's gonna make a fun story anyway, is frozen yogurt. I hope you're as excited about frozen yogurt as I am. Probably not. I don't think there's really anyone else in the entire universe who's as excited about frozen yogurt as I am. Depending on which social media networks, whatever, follow me on, you might be annoyingly aware that I work out a lot. I am always in the gym, always eating healthy foods, always being one of those obnoxiously annoying, fit, healthy people that everybody hates when they're eating a Big Mac. I'm not gonna preach to you about eating healthy or whatever. Like, if you like McDonald's and that's your thing, eat some McDonald's. I'd be lying if I said I didn't like Big Macs, okay? That was probably the biggest thing that I miss since becoming a vegetarian, pescatarian, whatever. Every time I tell someone I'm a pescatarian, they're like, oh, isn't that a religion? And I'm like, that's Episcopalian. Okay, all right. Not gonna try and convince you otherwise. Pescatarian basically means I'm a vegetarian who eats seafood, which Mr. Creepypasta and Creepypasta Jr., both of them, hate seafood. That's one thing that drives this community apart, that some of us love seafood and some of us hate seafood. It's not even one of those like agree to disagree type things. It's one of those you bring fish anywhere near me, I'm gonna slap you sideways type debates. We have gotten completely off topic. I'm looking at my timer right now. I'm 3 minutes and 45 seconds in, and I've not said a single word about frozen yogurt other than just introducing the topic. So back to my topic, which was frozen yogurt. I'm really active, so, and I eat really, really healthily. Try and get in shape for convention season so that I can look good in all the pictures for my contracts for the cosplay companies that sponsor me. Anyway, frozen yogurt. I promise this is gonna be about frozen yogurt eventually. About at least once or twice a week, I allow myself to have eat things I want without feeling bad ever about them day. Basically, I do not pay attention to what I'm eating at all. I could just be double fisting like sweet potato fries and not even care. Just at least once a week, I do that. My favorite double fisting sweet potato fries day event is going to the local frozen yogurt shop right down the road from my apartment. The thing about getting frozen yogurt, I don't know if you've ever done this, is I feel like I have to prepare you because I'm telling you to go get frozen yogurt right now. But unless you've gotten it before, I don't think you're mentally or emotionally prepared for what you're about to go through. So much judgment in a buffet. Or at least imaginary judgment in my brain. I know like probably no one else in the line is thinking, oh, that girl just put this on her food, that's weird. Because my thing is I smother things in salad dressings. Most of the time it's not salad. I don't even think I put salad dressings on my salads, but I put salad dressing on everything else. So I'm constantly feeling judged when it's like a buffet style line type thingy. I assumed you got frozen yogurt from and then you would walk up to the counter and then you would pay, buffet type place. That's another thing, when you get to the end of a line at one of those buffet places, like a cafeteria style, that's what I'm trying to say. Yeah, anyway, cafeteria style, that's what I assumed that your frozen yogurt place was like. So, one day I decided, forget what other people think, my best friend and I went and we went to a frozen yogurt place, literally right down the street from where I live. It was like I assumed, you cup and then there's like 80 different flavors of frozen yogurt on the wall. You know when you fill your little cup with frozen yogurt? That all sounds great. I can handle that. Then you get to the topping bar. I have a problem. There's about 200 toppings available, not to mention all the different like flavored syrups you can add. And every time I go in there, I tell myself, hey, you got this flavor. All of these toppings aren't gonna taste good with this one flavor. Try to get toppings that will taste good with the flavor that you chose. Nope, that's not how it happens, folks. I get to that topping bar. Say I got pistachio or banana flavored yogurt, which is my two favorites. Things that don't go with pistachios. Captain Crunch. What do? Load the bowl full of Captain Crunch. Literally every single topping, regardless of whether it tastes good or not with said flavor, gets dumped into my bowl. And they do it like by weight, like they charge you by weight. By the time I get up to the scale thingy for them to weigh my frozen yogurt, it weighs as much as a newborn. And it's got pretty much every topping, except for pineapple, which I'm allergic to, crammed into that bowl. Just covered with like every sauce that was available to me. I have a problem. It's like a weird addiction. Every time I go in there, which now it's like a weekly thing, I go in every week for frozen yogurt, at least once a week. I tell myself that certain toppings don't taste good with certain flavors. Like, you know, brownies don't always taste so good with like passion fruit. Things don't taste good together. But I decide to get them anyways. Like halfway through eating my frozen yogurt, A, there's so many toppings, I can't even get to the yogurt. So by the time I get to the yogurt, it's just yogurt soup. And that's gross. The reason why I'm not twisted with ice cream toppings. It's gross. And I sabotage my own yogurt. So this is kind of, it was pointless. It was 9.5 minutes, judging by my timer, of me warning you to not be overwhelmed by the topping bar. Frozen yogurt places. I also had another point to this video, but I, for the life of me, can't remember what it was. Besides, frozen yogurt is delicious and you should go out and try some. Pace yourself so you don't get overwhelmed. I did. Ah, got a hair in my mouth. That was gross. Did it on camera. That was beautiful. So anyway, that was my fun vlog for tonight. I bet like a million of you, there's like, I have like 6,000 subscribers, a million of you, like 100 of you, maybe if 100 of you end up watching this, probably like, what was the point of this video? And the answer to that is, there is none. There is no point to this video. There's no point to any of the vlogs I make. Sorry. I hope you had as much fun with me wasting now 11 minutes of my time as I enjoyed wasting 11 minutes of your time. By the time I finish editing this, probably won't be 11 minutes long, but you know. Being said, I love all of you. I hope you all have an awesome April 13th, I think it is. But yeah, I hope you guys have an awesome day and an awesome weekend. And maybe I'll see you at Japan Fest tomorrow. And I love all of you. You're all so awesome. Okay, I'm gonna go because it's starting to get weird and uncomfortable for everybody. All right, I love you guys. And you know what I always say? Have a lovely day. Oops, I did the hand thing in the wrong order. Have a lovely day.